I just want this. I want to bring an illustration out to you guys because I want this to be real for us. I don't want this to be abstract because this is tough stuff. And sometimes it's hard to get it in our minds because we just take it so for granted. But I want you to be thinking of this, especially when you're talking to other people, because this is where you're going to challenge them. We're going to bring in the evidence, but first of all, we challenge them on a more basic level that they need God, right? So take every thought captive to the obedience of Christ, every area of your life. Any subject, every category, evaluate it in the light of Scripture and explain it biblically. Everything, man. And I'm telling you, you got to start thinking like this. Try it sometime. Try it through the day when you're watching the news. What's their worldview? Where are they coming from? What are their presuppositions? Look at things, and that shows that you watch. The things that you see, things that people do, why are they doing that? You know, what's it say about where they're at and what they believe, what they don't believe? How would I challenge that if I heard that? You know, what would I say to that objection? All those kinds of things. And take it from a biblical perspective. I'm talking everyday things, everyday conversations. I'm going to end this portion with an illustration. And I want us to kind of think through this in biblical categories. And again, Luke's going to do more of this. But my daughter was having a conversation, my youngest daughter was having a conversation at Easter time with a very nice family, very nice person there. And she was talking about the resurrection. And she was, you know, kind of explaining it and going on. And very nice girl, who's a nurse, wasn't getting it, you know, because she's talking about, you know, Jesus was raised on this day, it's why we celebrate. And it was just kind of not connecting. And this person said, I don't know much about all of that, about resurrection, about Jesus and stuff, but what I do saves lives. She's a nurse. Okay, now listen, let's do this. Let's do this right now, okay? Let's think every thought captive to the obedience of Christ. Think of the categories. Let me ask you this. Think of the categories of what it means to be a nurse. What does a nurse do primarily? What's a nurse do? What's her concern? Yes, he saves lives. Preserving life. That's what a nurse does. Cares. Compassion, caring. These are all things that go into being a nurse, a doctor in that way. I'm just thinking about nurse right now. So yes, it points to being created in God's image. His concern for life and the preservation of it. So you know that right away. See what I'm saying? You say, hey, I'm a nurse. I got things important to do. I'm saving people's lives. You're not really talking about resurrection. What's that have to do? Why should I even think about that? Here's why. Think of the categories. What's a nurse do? Preserving life, caring for life, showing compassion, all those good things. So here, Christian, life as a Christian, say as a Christian, life comes from God. And you, and I've said this to my cardiologist, Dr. Rubin. He doesn't, you know, he's nowhere near a believer or anything like that. But I've said things like this to him. But here's the nurse story. You're a nurse. And as a nurse, the things that you do reflect the very character and nature of God, whether you know it or not. Every time you care for a patient, right? Every time you do what you do as a nurse, every time you show compassion, every time you show concern for their well-being, right? A willingness to bring comfort and to bring healing, you're showing that you're created in the image of God. That's what it is. That's where it comes from. Where else would that come from? If we're just here as an accent, who cares? God's a God of compassion. God's a God of life. You understand? This is where tough-mindedness, remember? Be tough. Be tough. Because it's going to be easy to get distracted or, you know, put down. Or yeah, of course. No, but really, why? Why? This is why. No matter what else may motivate you, might be the money. Is there good money in nursing? Yeah. Pretty good, right? It might be the idea of being a nurse. But even if you don't believe in God, you show evidence that you do know him by reflecting him in what you do. Right? It doesn't matter if you're a teacher, if you're a nurse, wherever you're at. There's always that reliance on God. So start thinking like that. And we want people to wrestle with that. Show them that. Now, also, you can say, as a Christian, what you do as a nurse, guess what? And I've said this to Dr. Rubin. He just laughs at me. I said, it points back to something. It points back to a time before sin and disease even entered this world, right? Before sickness came in, before death came into the world. So in a way, doctor, in a way, nurse, what you're doing is getting back to that garden, right? Before sin entered the world. I know it's a little abstract. It might be a little, but really, that's what it is. Why did he do it anyway? Why is that? In a real sense, where did sickness and disease and death come from? It came from sin. Where? In the garden. So what you're doing, in a way, points back to that. But you know what? Yeah, it is good. Because also, in addition to that, it points forward. It looks, what you do as a nurse, caring, compassion, love, healing the sick, looks forward to a time when the Bible promises there will be no more disease, there will be no more death, there will be no more sickness. This is why Jesus came, to reverse that curse, to deal with sin, right? And the consequence of that sin is sickness and death. Right? How did he do that? Through his life, his death, and his resurrection. That's how it fits in. Now, I know it sounds complicated and cool, but it's not. It's just, that's really the truth. And that's tough-minded. Now, if you say that to a person, they might laugh you out of the building like my doctor does to me, you know, or they might really wrestle with it and think about it. But nevertheless, it's true. And that's what we want to do. That's what we want to point to. Take every category, every thought captive to the obedience of Christ, because you can't do anything in this world apart from relying on him. And we want to make that apparent to people. Capisce? You get that? Really important that you get that.